Hey guys, Vasho! This is Blaze the Movie and it's time for another movie review. This time I will be reviewing the movie The Hangover Part 3. Now, I went into this movie expecting it to be shit because the trailers didn't look so impressive to me. But I am glad to say that I was pleasantly surprised. This is by no means a great movie, but I will say that it is better than I expected it to be. So the plot of the movie goes basically something like this. Al Garner and his friends are chased by a gang and the gang leader Marshall threatens to kill one of Alan's friends if he doesn't get back the gold that was stolen from Marshall. Now I'm going to start by talking about the characters of the movie. Zach Galifianakis plays as one of the four main characters of the movie. Alan Garner. Now he is a very good character and he's also a very good guy in a bad situation. I don't really think I need to explain who the four main characters of the movie are, because if you have seen the other two Hangover movies you already know who they are. But in case you don't, I am going to explain. They are basically a couple of friends who hang around with each other a lot and really care about each other, and they go on adventures, which they also do in this movie. But it's a lot different from the other two movies. Which leads me to what I want to talk about next, the idea for this movie. I have to say, I think it was a good idea to take this movie a different route than the other two Hangover movies. Instead of the four main characters waking up, not knowing what the hell happened, they have to deal with a bunch of gangsters instead. Even though I don't think it's a great idea, it's at least a lot better than the idea for the second Hangover movie, which was basically a rehash of the first one. So I will give the director a props for trying to take the movie a different route. Now the next character that I want to talk about is Marshall, played by John Goodman. Now Marshall is a gang leader who wants to get his fucking gold back. And he threatens to kill one of Alan's friends if he doesn't get what he wants. You know, this guy, Marshall, is such a fucking asshole. And that's what makes him a good villain. Yeah, I do think that he's a pretty good villain. He is cruel, tough, mean, and he does everything to get exactly what he wants. Now, I don't think he's a fantastic villain, but I do think that he is a pretty good one. The next character of the movie that I want to talk about is Leslie Chow, played by Ken Jeong. Now Chow is basically the guy who stole gold from Marshall. And you know what? I think that Chow is a very good character. He is a guy that you don't want to fucking mess with. By the beginning of the movie, he is Alan's friend. But later in the movie, it is debatable whether he is a true friend of Alan or not. But regardless, I still think that he is a very good character. Don't fucking mess with him. You will regret it. Now it's time to talk about the humor. I will admit that I did laugh a couple of times during this movie. There were a lot of lines which I found to be very funny. But I can't say that this is entirely a laugh out loud comedy. This movie does have its share of serious moments. In fact, this movie is more serious than the other two Hangover movies. Which is fine, I have no problem with a movie being in a serious tone. Another thing about the humor is the fact that there were some jokes that made me wanna facepalm, and I didn't laugh at them at all and found them very unfunny. But there were just some jokes that made me do that. It's certainly not most of the jokes in the movie. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. I would say that this is a good conclusion to the Hangover trilogy. I can't say that it's a great conclusion because this is not a great movie. But it's still a good one and pretty enjoyable. It's a lot better than the second Hangover movie, that's for sure. But it's not nearly as good as the first one. Now, even though The Hangover Part 3 is better than I expected it to be, it's still not a great movie by any means. But it is enjoyable, and for that I'm going to give this movie one thumb up. I can't possibly recommend this movie. If you want to have fun, well then maybe you can check this movie out. But there are so much better movies out there. If you really, 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 really want to have fun, I recommend you see Fast and Furious 6 instead. Well guys, that's all I gotta say. Thank you for watching and have a great day.